Now, I would like to invite Chandramohan to, he has got All India 25th rank, to come and share with you his experiences. Right.
Hello everyone. First of all, I would thank Mishra sir to give me this opportunity to share my experience over here. When I start sharing my point of view, I would just say one thing, that when you are in the initial stages of your preparation, guidance is one of the most important thing. Because what happens is, at times, for the first few months, we are directionless and we are not able to understand that what has to be done. And we have some our own hypothetical thoughts and we feel that we are not on the right track, we are misleading ourselves, and that impacts our confidence a lot. So this is one thing I would like to discuss a lot in my discussion over here for the next 15-20 minutes. But first and foremost, let me talk about the most important thing by sharing my own experience, which all of us have in mind. Even when I was sitting over there and I was preparing, the first thing was, exam niklega bhi ya nahi? As simple as that, are we capable enough to crack this examination or not? And this thing will naturally come to our mind, because if we look at the odds, there are more than 10 lakh applicants who have this aspiration and fill up the forms. And overall there are 1000 seats, and for IAS there are 100 seats. So even I had this thinking ki toppers are class apart people who would be very intelligent or who would be very hard working, or who they are a different kind of human beings. But now standing over here, I realize that they are absolutely normal people. It is not their intellect or their abilities that differentiate them, but more of their attitude that have helped them to reach over there. And if I share you, then I'll tell my own example what was with me. When I was in college, I started preparing for civil services examination. There was a topper from my college. I approached him and asked him what to prepare, and I started preparing. For 3-5 months I prepared, and then I started appearing in tests, and I was getting very, very bad ranks. Say 5000 people are appearing in the test, then my rank would be 2000 or 2500. So then I had all those things in my mind that I am going directionless, I don't have the capability in me, I don't have memory, meri memory bahut buri hai. So all those things made me feel ki bhai UPSC chodo, it's not my cup of tea, and I gave up UPSC. I was in college, so I got a campus selection in Deloitte, so I thought let me join corporate sector and have some good time rather than preparing for civil services. So I left my preparation, and for 2 years I was not preparing. When I was in Deloitte and I worked for a year and a half, I had two good realizations. One was that to follow your interest. Over there I was having a very good life, I was getting good money, and every weekend I would hang out with friends and enjoy. But I would have never excelled in Deloitte, because that was not my area of interest. My area of interest was always in civil services, but just out of fear that mere bas ki nahi hai, I was trying to keep it aside. And second thing was, I realized that risk taking is very important in our life. We all are in our 20s, and 20s is the time to experiment rather than stabilize yourself with something. So if you have an interest, you need to pursue it and go for it. So I think these were the two reasons that made me quit my job, and I prepared for civil services, and I got 617 rank last year, and I worked more on it, and I was able to get rank 25. So what actually helped me, if I talk, I'll try to break it in two parts. One is I'll talk about my preparation, hardcore preparation, and second I'll talk about my overall mental preparation for this examination. So what was different in me as an aspirant when I was in college and as an aspirant when I left my job and started preparing? The difference, I would say, lied on 3 or 4 factors. First and foremost was clarity of goal. Over here, all of you who are sitting have this dream of becoming an IAS or a civil servant, but most of you have this infatuation, not an actual dream. What I mean, the difference is that civil services, when we look at it, we feel, oh, a lot of power, a lot of prestige, a lot of recognition, so let's go for it. But this is a very superficial reason for preparing for civil services. You need to have a very strong, clear-cut mindset that why am I going for civil services. For example, if today any one of you gets a very good job, or many of you might be preparing with a backup, or many of you will have a lot of things in mind that let me do this, that, as well as many other things. So if this would have been your dream, then it will be one single minded focus on civil services only, at least for the first or first two attempts. That is the mind of clarity you need to have, because once you have clarity, only then the real effort will come out. With me, the same thing was there. When I left my job, I knew that there is no going back. I have to do this, and that held me in focusing fully into preparation for civil services examination. So I think that was the first big thing that helped me, clarity of goal, that why you actually want to be a civil servant. Ask yourself and be clear on this part. Second thing I feel what helped me was my attitude towards my preparation. Pehle, I was, if I won't perform in test, I will give up. If I'm not able to memorize things, I will give up. If I feel the course is very wide, I will think that I am not capable of doing it. So all these things, ups and downs, failures, would depress me or frustrate me. But now I had a very good attitude towards preparation. I knew very clearly that all these are part and parcel of this preparation, and I have to get used to it. And probably that helped me a lot. One basic example, if I take, all of us would have learned cycling in our initial stages. And my when I used to ride, I would fall every time. And I think most of you would have fallen a lot of times. But none of us gave up, because we knew that this is a part of learning, that we will fall, we will have issues, but ultimately we'll learn it. Same is with any competitive examination. If you have to crack it, you need to have a right attitude towards it. You need to know that there will be failures, there will be situations where will you doubt your capabilities, but you have to come across them and keep moving forward. That was the second thing. Third and the most important thing that helped me was interest in course of preparation. यहाँ पे सब लोग टॉप ऑफ द समिट पे पहुँचना चाहते हैं, पर ट्रैक करके पहाड़ पे कोई नहीं चढ़ना चाहता. यू वॉन्ट टू रीच योर डेस्टिनेशन, बट यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू इन्जॉय योर जर्नी. सो ऐसे तो नहीं हो सकता सिविल सर्विसेज में. इफ़ यू एक्चुअली वॉन्ट टू गेट इन टू सर्विसेज, यू नीड टू इन्जॉय द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रिपरेशन. यू नीड टू इन्जॉय व्हाट यू आर स्टडिंग. इट्स नॉट अ यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन जहाँ पे यू कैन क्रैम अप थिंग्स एंड अपीयर एंड यू विल गेट थ्रू. नो, इट्स अ प्रोसेस टू nurture your personality, and that nurturing in you will only happen when you will actually enjoy the process of preparation. Initially even I was not able to enjoy, because kuch yaad nahi hota tha, marks aate nahi the, so I used to think that it doesn't give you confidence, so you don't enjoy it. But what I did was I studied very systematically for the initial few months, and when I started studying very systematically for the initial few months, I was able to understand things very easily. And if I would discuss this with my friends, they would say, oh, you have a very good perspective on things. Or if I write a test in my coaching, I would get marks. So that would again make me feel good about me. So that is how you have to generate interest. Initially, you will have to push. And once you will start getting small success, you will automatically start enjoying it. So interest is a very important thing. And last and the most important thing is optimism. You have to have a right attitude and positivity in you when you're preparing, because you will meet a lot of people who will keep on criticizing you or keep on saying that beta 1 lakh people, 10 lakh people are appearing, what is your chance of getting through it, or something or the other. They will tell you, look at people from IIT or IIM are preparing, so how will you get through it? Don't ever think on those things. You need to have a very 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 positive perspective, and if you have optimism, if you make efforts, then definitely things will become very simple for you. Because it is normal people who do abnormal things. When they have the right perspective towards it, their attitude and their effort in a combination helps them in doing up things. So this is on my mental preparation aspect. Now let me talk about actual preparation for civil services. Before I talk about preparation, I'll tell you what I feel UPSC expects. It's a three-dimensional aspect. One is knowledge. You need to have the knowledge of the subject matter of civil services. Now what I mean by knowledge, say let me take up a topic, inflation. So kevlo keval ye nahi ki aapne inflation ki definition rat li and you think, oh, you know about inflation. You need to know that what are the factors that leads to inflation and what can be the outcome of inflation and how inflation is linked with other aspects. So that is conceptual clarity about a particular topic, that will help you a lot. So this is the most important thing, having knowledge of the subject matter, conceptual knowledge. Second is analysis in thinking. Okay, now you have knowledge, but now you need application as well, because you are an administrator. So you have to apply that knowledge in real life scenario. So what I used to do, if I read a concept, say inflation, then I would link that how is inflation related to other aspects of economy, how is inflation related to many other things. Say if I say a drought has come to a particular place, how will it impact inflation? Or if inflation has come, how will it impact interest rate? Or if inflation has come, or how is inflation related to our fiscal deficit? So this is the kind of thinking you have to do, that linking one part with other part of the syllabus to get an overall perspective on things. So in thinking and analysis is second thing where you have to focus upon. And third and the most important thing is articulation. That how are you able to deliver in 150 to 200 words? Lot of people think that, oh, we don't have this capability, so that is why we are not able to do. Let me tell you one simple thing, that most of us in our initial stages were not even able to speak properly. If I talk about me, I had very bad communication skills, but it developed in the course of time. Similarly, writing is also a way of articulation through writing. That can also be developed over a course of time, and you have to keep in mind that when you are preparing, you have to focus on your articulation abilities as well. Interview checks your speaking verbal capabilities, and mains checks your actual articulation ability through writing. So this is has to be the other area of focus. So knowledge, analysis and articulation, these are the three areas. Now let me talk about the current trend of civil services. If you look at prelims and mains, in prelims they are trying to check our factual knowledge. Factual knowledge both on static and current part. Current part is becoming more and more relevant. If you look at this year paper also, 65 to 70 questions were directly related to current affairs. And in static part, they will be asking you factual questions and few conceptual questions from polity, economy, geography. That is the breakup of prelims. And if you look at mains, then mains has become more of analysis oriented paper. What I mean by analysis, that they will not ask you salient features of a particular act or trying to ask you that discuss on this. Now they will ask you how this particular act will have an impact on XYZ particular thing. What is your perspective and what can be done? So there comes your analysis part, and that will be more or less very much related to current affairs, but will also expect you to have a basic understanding of the static parts of economy, polity, geography, etc. So your preparation has to be such that you have to be very cohesive with your current and static part. So right from day one, you have to ensure that you focus on both these areas. Now how will you do this? You are starting your classes over here under guidance of Mishra sir. What now has to be done on your part is two things. Let me talk about current affairs first, and then I'll talk about how do you cover up the static part. In current affairs, when you're starting, your newspaper is your Bible. There you will have to spend a lot of time. I would say 1.5 to 2 hours is something that is required in the initial stages. And what will you read? When I started Hindu, I literally hated that paper, because I was not able to understand anything, and I was like, ki, I don't know how do other people study and cover up. Now what I feel is, when you are studying newspaper, if you are reading an article, you might not be able to understand an article, don't worry about it. But you have to do two very important things initially. First is understanding the technical words given in an article. Say for example, you are reading an article which was given on repo rate raise from 7% to 8% or something like this. In that article, there will be many keywords like repo rate, RBI, say inflation, interest rate, etc. Just Google it and try to understand what are these technical words, because it is because of these technical words you are not able to understand that particular issue. So next time you will read it, you will be able to understand it properly. And second thing that you have to do is understand the basics, background of a particular issue. Say for example, tomorrow you read in news that ISIL has made an attack on a particular country, and USA says It is the biggest global threat in the world. So you need to know what is ISIL, where it is operating, what harm is it doing to the rest of the world, and why it is considered to be the biggest global threat. Background understanding through Wikipedia. So these two things you will have to focus in the initial stages a lot. And if you do this for 1 or 2 months, automatically understanding newspaper will become very, very simple thing for you. And then when you're reading newspaper, just keep one thing in mind. Remember your whole syllabus for prelims and for mains. And then what I used to do, I would make up a copy. I would divide that copy into 5-6 parts, say polity, economy, international relations. And whenever I'll read an article and I think it relates to polity, I will try to just note it down in brief points.
What I mean by brief points?
Say for example, there is an article on NPA, a big article that is discussing everything. So when I read that article, I would do one simple thing. What is NPA? One line. Why NPA is a challenge? 3 or 4 points given. What are the solutions for NPA? 3 or 4 points. NPA is non-performing assets of a bank. They loan you, you don't pay them back, it becomes a bad asset for them. That is NPA. So just giving you an example like this, you have to cover up for prelims and mains. That is the current part. Now let me talk to you about the static part. For static part, I'll tell you one simple thing, that you have to ensure your preparation is systematic. The course is like a sea, and if you will jump into it, you will not be able to cross through it. So you have to have targets, small targets with you, and as well you have to ensure you prepare with consistency in a systematic manner. So how do you go about it? What I would do is one simple thing, and I'll ask, expect you, if you do the same thing, that will help you a lot. Say you are coming over here to attend your next class, which will be on a particular topic. Before I would go to a class, I would read that topic from a standard book or the course material which sir will be giving to you. So that when you go to a class, you are not like, ye kahan aa gaya main, kya chal raha hai. That should not happen, else you will not be able to understand things. So just give us brief reading. You will not be able to understand totally, but you will be able to relate when the topic will be discussed in the class. So I would give a pre-reading to a topic before I come to a class. Aap yahan class mein aaye, you attended the lecture, you will have questions when that teacher will be telling you, will not be able to relate it or something. You can ask questions now. Earlier you will not be able to, in a situation to even ask questions. Now that topic is covered in the class, you ask questions, you go back to home, and when you go back to home, ensure you read whatever was taught in the class in your notes, and as well you take up a standard book or the course material, and aaj ki aaj hi, today only you cover up that topic of the syllabus that was taught up in the class, so that you don't pile up things for tomorrow. That is very important thing. If you will not do even for 2-3 days this particular thing, things will start piling up, and when things start piling up, it becomes very difficult to cover up. And many students make up this mistake that something is going in the coaching and they are doing something else. So that's a totally desynchronized form of preparation, and that will not lead you anywhere. So you need to have trust in what the teacher is teaching you, and ensure you cover up that part of your syllabus today only. And as well, keep some time to read the next topic that will be taught in tomorrow's class. I did this thing very systematically throughout my preparation, and that helped me in ensuring that I had covered up all the topics. I even made notes of whatever I was reading in current affairs and whatever I was reading in my classes plus standard books. What I used to do, today something is taught in the class, I read it, I referred a standard book, I will read it twice or thrice on that day only, and whatever key points I think were missing in the class lecture related to that topic, either I will mark in the book only, or I will try to note them down on a A4 sheet and link up with that, so that I am satisfied that this part of my syllabus is over. That is first thing, preparation. Preparation has three aspects in this. One is covering up a topic. Second is making up note so that you are able to consolidate things. And third thing is evaluation. Now, how will you evaluate yourself? One way of evaluation is, as soon as the topic gets over, try to solve last year prelims paper. Prelims, you will have a 20 year. Just whatever topic you have read, see in last 20 years prelims what questions have come and are you able to solve them or not. That will help you in analyzing that whether you are on right track or not. Second, you can even see mains questions that have come out from that topic. And third is, there will be very regular tests taking place in your classes as well, so as to help you in evaluating yourself that are you going on the right track or you are not able to go as per directions. So these three things, if you do systematically, preparing, covering up your course syllabus, notes making and consolidation of things, and regular evaluation. Systematically doing all these things will definitely help you in ensuring that you reach a particular level of preparation, which is a must in this examination. After that level, to some extent, it is our destiny as well. Now it comes that how much patient you are and how much optimistic you are. After that level, even I don't know I would have got rank 25. I might have not got anything in civil services. There the factor of luck will come into picture, so you cannot do anything about that. But if you are prepared and if you are systematic, then nobody can stop you from getting into civil services. You might take one or two more extra attempt. That might happen because of being unlucky, but you will sure shot get into services if you have a very systematic way of preparation. Like last year, I was able to score 617 rank. So it was because of my systematic preparation. After that, I tried to analyze that where am I missing. And I realized I have to work on three areas. One was answer writing. I have to improve my articulation skill. I worked out on that. Second was essay. That is one area where people generally don't work because they think, oh, English is needed and I don't have an English. I have pathetic English, but still I could score 149 marks in English in essay this year, which is, I think, among the highest or probably the highest, just because I prepared for it very systematically. So anything can be done. Don't think that mujhse ye nahi hoga ya ye nahi hoga. If you have a proper approach, you will be able to work out on things. And third was interview. I was very underconfident when it comes to speaking, especially an impromptu question when it comes up to me. So I tried to work out on that. I also took help of Chanakya IAS. I took help of Sir. That also helped me a lot in getting confidence in me that I can do well. So working out on these three areas actually helped me in ensuring that all those areas where I was missing out, I could do well. So this is last thing I would like to tell, that in course of your preparation, when you evaluate yourself at every level, also try to analyze that where are you missing. So it has to be a feedback loop throughout your preparation, understanding what is missing, working on that, understanding what is missing, working on that. So cumulatively, if you do all these things, then I don't think you will face any issue. You have very good teachers, you have a proper classroom, you have library, you have guidance of good teachers. Now you have to make your self effort as well to ensure your preparation is very much coherent. So keep right attitude and make right efforts. And I hope you are standing here next time and delivering the lecture to another set of people. Thank you.